So more and more, we are witnessing the banning of legal but offensive speech, something that the European Union and now Britain is paving the way for. Britain seems to be even more draconian when it comes to this, and it's very interesting. They call it legal but harmful. In other words, it's something that the overwhelming amount of people believe that it shouldn't be banned, but the people in power, because it questions their power, believes it should be banned. Because if the overwhelming amount of people would believe that, okay, well, this is actually genuinely harmful, then they would pass it into legislation, and it would be banned by law. But it's not. In other words, it's legal, like you're allowed to say it, but it's harmful, so it needs to be banned. And this is very interesting, right? Because of the way technology advanced. If we didn't have social media, I'm really curious if they were to start listening in to what people talk over the phone, like put microphones into people's phones. Because the Communist Party in Romania was doing this. Would they have informants to know what people are talking about, what people are thinking? Because the Communist Party in Romania did this. Would they go through people's mail to see if there's harmful misinformation when you're sending a letter to grandma? Because I genuinely believe that this is the mentality, and if this was what they were doing, that it would abhor people. But because social media is a new invention, and it is the de facto marketplace of ideas, the government wants to censor it. And the European Union told Elon Musk that if they do not censor the legal but harmful speech, they're going to ban Twitter in the European Union. I don't know how they're going to do this. I have no idea what plans they could even have in place, because the European Union doesn't have the same power like the Chinese government or the Soviet Union. But, you know, hopefully, in the name of safety, not for us, but for the people in power, they will find ways. Now, Britain is taking a different approach. They're not going to censor social media, but they're going to fine it 10% over their turnover, which means around $10 billion or so per fine. For Meta, for example, absolutely insane. I hope that Facebook would just ban its website in the United Kingdom, and then maybe the politicians would actually force some consequences. Because most people who use social media are the younger generation, and the younger generation, if they wouldn't be able to access it, then they would start protesting and they would start voting. For example, this happened in the United States when the concept of abortion was taken away. Well, you had many young people that like to fuck who then went to the voting polls. And it's the same thing. You know, you're going to have a lot of people that like to Twitch stream in their hot tub bath, and they're going to encourage their fans to go vote. I mean, this is what happens when you start messing around with the younger generation and their toys. I understand. You know, like, sometimes you can fuck the economy, nothing happens. You can lock people in their homes, nothing happens, because the young generation just likes to watch Netflix anyway. But when you start fucking with their toys, they actually do start to care. So this is the only way, you know, like if the social media would just go, oh, so you're going to fine us if we do not remove the legal but harmful speech? Okay, well, we can't provide our services in the United Kingdom then. And then you're going to see something funny happening. But the way in, for how they got to this place, is with the social media giants face multi-million pound fines if they fail to ban child accounts. So in the sick mind of the British government, it is the responsibility of the corporations to parent children. It's not the responsibility of the parents to parent children. No, it's the responsibility of Zuckerberg. As if my child, if they were like 5 years old and they would create a Facebook account, Zuckerberg should be the one coming up and slapping the phone out of the hands of my child, not the parent. I mean, it's such an insane logic that now private corporations are the ones that should parent children. It's such a Western concept. Like, it doesn't even exist here in Eastern Europe. Like, here's an example, right? Playing in the middle of the street. It's dangerous and harmful. I would say playing in the middle of the street is more dangerous and harmful than having an account on social media. And they talk about online bullying and, you know, like the children being exposed to all of this shit, right? So, if a child plays in the middle of the street, whose fault is it? Is it the fault of the government or the fault of the parent? Like, here in Eastern Europe, we believe it's the fault of the parent. If the child plays on the street and actually gets injured, the parent gets called into questioning. Where were you? What were you doing? Why was the child playing in the middle of the street? Why weren't you capable of providing a better education for your children, right? That is the normal, healthy way of thinking. But I guess because in the West you have a different way of thinking now, where the children belong to the government and the institutions, well, then it's the job of the teacher and the job of the schools and the job of the corporations to educate your child, which is absolutely abhorrent, right? So they apparently have to create ways to follow, like, the accounts of children and ban them. And I'm like, why, though? Where are the parents? What the fuck are they doing? Not to mention, you know, like, the parent knows the child better. Like, maybe a child at the age of 16 is fully capable of using social media. Other children, maybe they can be at the age of 20 and they still have no idea how to fucking do it. You know, like, it depends from case to case. And I think the parent, in each case, knows better. I mean, look, if I want to let my kid, let's say he's 7 years old, and I want to let him play Neopets, and I supervise him, why is that a problem? Like, why shouldn't that be an issue between me and my child? Why should the government get involved? Why should the corporations get involved? Like, if I know how to supervise the interaction with the internet. So, completely bewildering, but all of this is to create systems in place to monitor on accounts, to spy on people, and then to work with the government. And we saw what happened with the Twitter scandal. Like, this is not hyperbole or, you know, just fiction anymore. It is a actual reason of concern that your privacy is being violated by the government working hand in hand with these tech companies, and the tech companies often doing the bidding of the politicians. And we saw it's left-leaning, right-leaning, doesn't matter. It's the people with power that get to decide. And I find it very interesting and fascinating how TikTok is left out of this conversation. Did you notice this? Isn't that fucking fascinating? So, every time they talk about Twitter, they talk about Facebook, they talk about Google, they never talk about TikTok for some reason. The only person that talked about TikTok is Trump. I will tell you something also very interesting about TikTok, and you can do this experiment yourself. If you go to TikTok China and you set a VPN to make it look like you're from China, you're going to get videos about how to build furniture, life improvement books, how to work out, how to draw, how to improve yourself, and how to learn useful skills. Now, if you change your VPN address to the United States, you're going to see only content that is completely useless and garbage. You're going to see people twerking. You're going to see people inventing the 156th pronoun. You're going to see people encouraging you to not go to gym, not go to work, you know, like this type of stuff. And some people will say, well, yeah, but it's maybe like the culture. Fuck that shit. It's not. I mean, you go on Twitter right now when the algorithm is free and you can see the things that are trending. It's not the same with what's on TikTok. Like, the things that are trending in the US are things that your friends probably talk about. It's not like this whole bizarre world where it's only stuff that's completely useless. So, interestingly enough, TikTok is never within the conversation, ever. Like, it's never being brought up when it's about censoring and legal but harmful content or any of that. No, it's just Facebook. Why? Because they know that these companies would cave. They know that there are people within Facebook that are friendly to the government, as we saw with Twitter, and it justifies why Elon Musk had to fire so many people. And, well, it is what it is. I'm really curious to see where this is going to go. But, yeah, I mean, all these Western nations, I mean, we saw since the pandemic, they do not value liberty and freedom anymore. They do not trust their citizens. They are afraid of their citizens. They, like, the idea that citizens can talk to each other without someone being a chaperon and looming over them with trust and safety doesn't exist in the West anymore. Kind of sad. Let me know what you guys think, though. And as usual, I will see you in the comment section. Take care.